Born in 1930, Felix Guattari was a psychoanalyst, political militant, and philosopher. Prominent because of his collaborations with Gilles Deleuze, he was a well-developed theorist in his own right. Today I will be discussing his 1969 essay, Machine and Structure. Intended for Lacan's Freudian school in Paris, it was ultimately rejected and published in 1971 in the French publication Change. Guattari opens this text by clarifying that the distinction between machine and structure is a conceptual distinction, to use the language of Duns Scotus. He says, "In reality, a machine is inseparable from its structural articulations, and conversely, each contingent structure is dominated by a system of machines." From here, we follow into a matter of the definition of machine and structure. Adopting the concepts of generality and repetition from Deleuze's magnum opus, Difference and Repetition, Guattari relates structure with the order of laws, constituted by a substitution of particularities, and machines with the universal singularity of repetition. Guattari says of structure that it positions its elements by way of a system of references that relates each one to the others, in such a way that it can be itself related as an element. Guattari claims that the agent of action is contained in the structure, whereas machine is essentially remote from the agent of action. He says of the machine that the subject is always somewhere else. By extension, the subject of history is elsewhere as well. As such, the relationship of the subject of the structure to the machine is necessarily a relationship of alienation. Guattari says of the worker that their alienation to the machine led them to seek specialized professional work. He claims that the belief of the machine as simply a tool of the model worker is an oppressive myth found not solely in fascist-type, paternalistic slogans about work, the family, and patriotism, but also within various versions of socialism. He continues, "As compared with the work done by machines, the work of human beings is nothing." He further clarifies, "Human work today is merely a residual subwhole of the work of the machine." It is here that we find one of the earliest mentions of the concept of the war machine. It is invoked to describe the function of a discovery which moves across the structural field of theory, upsetting and rearranging everything so as to change it radically. Continuing his elucidation of the functions of the machine, Guattari says of the essence of the machine that its function is that of detaching a signifier from the structurally established order of things. He says that the machine is a repetition of the particular. To clarify, Guattari explains that the voice, as a speech machine, is the basis and determinant of the structural order of language. The human being, as an individual body, is caught where the machine and structure meet. He claims every change produced as a product of a machine will be accompanied by a system of anti-production. This anti-production belongs to the plane of the machine, and is the representative mode specific to structure. Continuing, he says of anti-production that its mode of imaginary expression is then that of the transitional fantasy. Anti-production is working out the manifest content of a dream. In response to Lacan's objet petit A, otherwise known as the object cause of desire, Guattari presents the objet machine petit A, a self for itself, unable to be absorbed into the references of the structure. He says of the object of desire that it represents the impossibility of an any complete refuge of the self inside oneself, but equally the impossibility of a radical passage to the other. As individual fantasies may attempt the impossible in merging these levels, group fantasy, Guattari says, superimposes the different levels. He claims, "The group, as a structure, fantasizes events by means of a perpetual, non-responsible coming and going between the general and the particular." The ultimate end of this circular motion of the group fantasy is death, destruction, and the radical abolition of any real identifying marks. It is this group structure that represents the subject for another structure as the basis of subjectivity that is clogged up, opaque, turned into the ego. Guattari points to the black community in the United States' reliance on an identification imposed by whiteness as an example of a structure functioning as a subject for another structure. Ending on a discussion about revolution, Guattari claims that the revolutionary period is when the machine represents social subjectivity for the structure. He says that the problem of revolutionary organization is the problem of setting up an institutional machine, which would necessarily not depend on social structures, particularly the state. He continues, what entraps and deceives us is that it looks today as though nothing can be articulated outside of the structure. An argument echoed 50 years later by Mark Fisher's claim that it is easier to imagine the end of the world than the end of capitalism. For Guattari, the socialist intention to seize control of the state's political power has fallen into this trap. Guattari exalts that the revolutionary program, as the machine for institutional subversion, should ensure fortification against any attempt to structuralize its subjective potential. He claims that a permanent grasp of machine effects upon the structure cannot be achieved through only one theoretical praxis, but necessarily presupposes the development of a specific analytical praxis for every level of organization of the struggle. Guattari ends this text by postulating that it is through this that we are able to locate the responsibility of those who are in any way in a position to articulate theoretical discourse in such a way that it imprints the class struggle at the center of unconscious desire.